Roadside Republic from Andhra Pradesh. Roadside Republic is a show that takes you everywhere, every day, across the country to get you the sights and sounds, the voices in the countdown to the big election in 2014. Today we come to you from Usmania University in Hyderabad, that has in many senses been described as the ground zero of the Telangana agitation. It's as though the entire state is on tenterhooks and all eyes are on developments in Delhi. Parliament has been stalled for the second consecutive day, working for hardly 15 minutes on the second day of the special session that was expected to take the all-important AP reorganization bill as well. Seema Andhra MPs, in fact, and also Telangana MPs and other leaders have had meetings in turn with central leaders as well as with the president, trying to also lobby support with other political parties either for or against the bill in that they hope will be presented in parliament shortly. Seema Andhra MPs in fact had gone on to force another meeting of the GOM in which they suggested at least 9 major amendments. The GOM, we are told, is considering some of them, and that's the reason why the cabinet in fact could not meet today to take up the Telangana bill for a final time before sending it to the president. But the Seema Andhra MPs Chiranjeevi, in fact, the union minister of state for tourism Chiranjeevi, in fact, came out and said that if these amendments are accepted, then they would allow the Telangana bill and they may even support the Telangana bill. Chiranjeevi, of course, one MLA who was elected in 2004 as a PRP MLA, as leader of the Praja Rajyam party that he started from Tirupati in August 2008. Lot has changed from 2004 to 2009 in Andhra Pradesh, 2009 now to 2014. In fact, in 2009, PRP had 18 MLAs and now Chiranjeevi is in fact part of the Congress. We travelled to Tirupati to find out what the ground situation there looks like. Tirupati, the temple town of Lord Venkateshwara, more popular elsewhere as Balaji. Most political parties in Andhra Pradesh tend to start their election campaign from here. On the Roadside Republic, we also start our journey in Andhra Pradesh from Tirupati.
In 2009, the star candidate for the Tirupati Assembly seat was Chiranjeevi, who made his political debut with the Praja Rajyam party. Riding on his popularity and promising social equity, he won the seat by nearly 11,000 votes. His party got 18 assembly seats and 16% of the vote share.
Facilities and better.
But now the Praja Rajyam has merged with the Congress and Chiranjeevi is a Rajya Sabha MP, showcasing India to the world as Union Minister of State for Tourism. The Congress candidate that Chiranjeevi defeated is now the YSR Congress MLA from here.
Election la varudilla korangaatam neenga aatringa
engalukku avanga aatranga rajyagala vandu romba aata aatranga.
What this man is saying is that before elections politicians dance before us, and after elections it is us who has to dance before the politicians. Just the way he makes the monkey dance, the politicians make the people dance.
Though the voices now on whether the state should remain bifurcated or remain united are political, but the agitation on the ground was started mainly by the students here in Usmania University as well. Before we chat with students here, we go across to Sri Venkateshwara University to get their concerns and their thoughts before bifurcation of the state. Over the last few months, in fact, there has been series of agitations in this place over the issue of whether or not the state should remain united or bifurcated. Is that going to be the biggest issue in these elections?
Yes, ma'am, this issue is only the major issue to be in 2014 elections mandate. Definitely, every party should know who party supported United Andhra. We will vote for them only.
As a youngster, you tell me, is that the biggest issue on which you are going to vote?
Yes, ma'am, it is the biggest issue. Why? Because we want Andhra Pradesh, not want to Telangana. That's why who support the Sima Andhra and who support the Andhra Pradesh, then we will go for vote that party.
Is this going to be your first election in which you are going to be voting?
No, this is my second election.
Okay.
If you ask my past experience, I have voted Mr. Chiranjeevi, who is not present, who is not presently our MLA. He is minister and
he doesn't even have his party any longer.
Any longer. Of course, we lost Kurnool, but now we are also losing Hyderabad. And we don't want it to. We don't want to lose Hyderabad. We want United Andhra. And we don't want to take another 20 years to raise up a new capital for us.
One of the big reasons that has been cited for wanting to keep Andhra Pradesh united is that job opportunities are all in Hyderabad. The corporate sector is in Hyderabad. The development has happened around Hyderabad. But I'm going to ask these MBA students, what difference does it make to their life? Does bifurcation going to affect your future? Did these agitations in your university make any difference to you?
Yes, bifurcation will definitely affect the student career as well as the curriculum of the actually, I am the MBA student, so we lost 75 days of curriculum. So this affects my studies as well as the career opportunities. Even most of the companies are not willing to come out to our campus for these campus elections.
I am going to go to Madam Professor and ask you, you were an active participant in these agitations. Why did you feel strongly that AP needs to remain united?
Because every opportunity is in the Hyderabad. Everybody wants to take Hyderabad from Sima Andhra. It is a very wrong decision taken by the Sonia Gandhi. I am strictly opposing that decision because she is not understanding the problems of Sima Andhra.
I am with a great hope and a very optimistic that the bill in the parliament will be defeated as it was defeated in Andhra Pradesh Assembly. The Andhra Pradesh members of Assembly has given a fitting reply to the Sonia Gandhi's move. Even the Bharatiya Janata Party leaders should also rethink. They should reconsider the decision. What I would like to appeal is that, madam, even for a person who has been given a hanging sentence, he will be asked what is your last desire before putting into that hanging. So, without even asking the people of Andhra Pradesh, they have given a sentence which is nothing short of a hanging, madam.
Will buns and dharnas and agitations, as you are saying, be able to stop bifurcation?
Yes, madam, definitely we will make this state united only with dharnas, boycotts and some other like Nirahar Dikshas, which is being held by the politicians. So even in Telangana also, the people are continuous the dharnas for so many days, then only the central government ready to give Telangana.
Doesn't that mean that they also feel very strongly about the issue?
Yes, madam, they wanted to be separate from AP state, but we are not wanted to separate from AP. Then what is the necessity to sit in home? We will definitely fight against, we will come to the roads and we will strike against it. We don't want to lose this AP state and our lives. And
the battle is not over yet?
No, the battle is still continue until the government makes a definite conclusion that we are not going to divide this state. This state is being united. Up to then, we will strike and we will make dharnas.
What these students in Usmani University are singing is about the sacrifices made by the students across the Telangana region in order that they must get a separate state. They've heard the concerns there. I'm going to go across straight and ask you, so near and yet so far, is that the feeling you get after so many months of struggle?
Absolutely. With a vertical divide seen after what is happening in Delhi regarding the AP Bhavan issue yesterday, where the chief minister has seen from the bus that the senior Congress ministers like Geeta Reddy, DK Arna and Sunita Lakshma Reddy were chased away, were dragged, were pulled down, but even then there is no response from him. The chief minister is acting completely for one biased region and the high command is not talking about this. We are definitely concerned, and people who are talking about consensus, the same statements earlier come from opposition that they will definitely give Telangana, they will support Telangana when the bill has come. Today, when the day has come, when the ultimate day has come that they have to support, today they are talking, the Bharatiya Janata Party is talking about consensus. There can never be a consensus because Sima Andhra's demand is of United Andhra Pradesh. Telangana's one slogan is Telangana state with Hyderabad as capital. There can never be a consensus.
concern?
There is in fact a lot of anguish and concern here that central leaders are talking about consensus in the BJP. BJP is talking about consensus being evolved in this region, and they are also talking about, in fact, Telangana 100 days after the NDA comes into power.
The tension is palpable. Everybody over here in Telangana are pretty confused. What is happening? For a lot of years, BJP has stood as a bedrock. And then today, suddenly, they are talking about consensus. And earlier, when on 23rd December 2009, Chidambaram had stated in the parliament that he's setting up a commission because there is no consensus. So at that point of time, the leader of opposition had told that consensus is not possible, and with BJP support, Congress can rely on.
Those consensus is not possible, but students that side, students this side have suffered a lot. I mean, everyone's lost months and months of academics. What is your thought on whether these kind of politics should enter campuses?
Definitely, because the students who want to get into the real-time scenario, into the real-time society, are concerned about the social issues. So definitely they are involved into the politics. This Telangana Institute is not a politics. It is a social demand which raised it from the people, which raised it from the sentiments of the people who have been discriminated, who have been deprived of rights, who have been given, who have not given any opportunities for them. For that reason, Telangana demand has come. So definitely the students who shall lead the agitation. But here in Telangana agitation, many students have committed suicides. But whereas in Simandhra agitation, the students are led by political parties, the demands are given by political parties. And
well, both sides would say that their concerns are very genuine, because students there also will articulate saying that we need an access to Hyderabad for educational institutions, for jobs, for whatever else that they think as their capital. After all, their capital has also been Hyderabad.
Yes, definitely. They are not being objected from any opportunity. The opportunity is abundantly provided for the people of Simandhra region. They are here. They are our citizens of India. We are all.
Post elections now, Congress was hoping to make electoral gains, obviously, in the Telangana region. If this doesn't happen, the anger of the people is going to perhaps be reflected in the elections. There is the unfortunate aspect here has been that in the attempt to bring about a geographical divide, there's been so much of an emotional divide between the two sides that really has been the very, very unfortunate development. All eyes certainly on Delhi, and here a lot of hope certainly on what can happen in parliament, and what they hope will be the birth of a new state before the big elections of 2014. So even I am going to ask them once again to sing that song that they very soulfully sing for the Telangana region, and that's been in fact one of the major the cultural kind of a movement that they had evoked, and tried to bring in more and more people into this movement using these kind of songs. We will come back to you on the Roadside Republic. Our reporters have been traveling all across the country. Already we have covered 1477 kilometers, 1477 kilometers traveling across the country. We will continue to bring you reports from across the country every day. The voices, the noises that will lead up to the big elections of 2014. Thanks for watching. Amar Udara Vandanam Padam.